The following pages have been reproduced with the kind permission of the Royal Highland and Agricultural Society of Scotland and Mr. B. Kennedy, the author of this book.
Right, I look to be 17 now. 19.
I got that off and then I spent about an hour grinding it back to something that looks like this.
Well, it's handy, that front screen, I can see what's there. I've got some primer mixed up, I'm going to give it a couple of coats of primer. But this ring must be a really old bit of metal because it's the rust penetrated it. So we'll give it a spray in and I'll bring you back. It's the point of your other tripod is the thing, doesn't it? Stay where you want it. There we go. I've changed the resolution to 1080p 60 in the indoor setting. Well, I've got the Bridgeport head apart and I've got the brakes out. And this is the problem. This see is a bit broken. Looks like tilled steel as well. That should be attached there, so when you turn it, it forces the brakes apart. But somebody's, or just it's gone with age, I suppose. So we need to do something with this. There is a slot there. I'll maybe just see if I can drill something out. Could weld it, I suppose, but then the weld's going to be not in a good place for the brakes. Right, I'll wait and see if I can drill this out. Could slot something into it, or maybe try and make a new one. I think I'm going to see if I can machine up a new one in the lathe, and then just grind. Well, we can turn it down to size, and then we can just grind the sides to be flat, I think, and it'll all be in one piece then, rather than some. Because there's a bit of work to get in here. So, six, I'll do it backwards, this is how we're going to put it back together. Six Allen screws, a drive belt, no, three screws into the brakes, and then there's three nuts on top of them on the outside, four springs in, four little springs that sit in round about it. Then this goes on, and then there's two screws go into it. There's also two wee screws, and very small Allen screws. An Imperial, but it's like the third one up from the bottom, so I don't know what size they are. nothing else to do. And then you've got your tensioner and that to put in and put the motor on.
And then you want to know about Bridgeport, go here, watch Barry's videos, he knows everything there is to know about Bridgeport. So this is a bit about what I'm doing.
The motor's a bit, the motor bearings are a wee bit rough. That motor's older than it looks. Either that, it's rubbish bearings. Right, I have been putting a bit of paint in as well. So that's two coats of primer on. I'm going to wait to put on a third coat. And while that's drying, we shall go out and see if we can machine up a new one of these. Fortunately, we need the milling machine, but we don't have it, so we'll come up with something else. Right, let's do this quick spray paint job. I'm using too much pressure, by the way, but it's just the way I like it. I think this old gun I've got, it doesn't like 5 or 10 psi, it likes about 100. Which is way too high, but it works. That's the rain on yet again. You'll hear my super quiet compressor coming on. Put the mask on. Oh, I'll be in trouble. This spray gun, I've probably had it for 20, 30 years. I don't use it that much. Right, we'll go lacing, see what we can find to make this bit. Maybe make it slightly different for the original. I'll just no doubt about it. proper gorilla stand, he would have magnetic feet. But you're not, are you? Cheap knockoff. There we go. Stuff to make it out of. Pins are going to be very hard. Hard to work, but I managed to hold it. See if we can get this to work. Don't think that's going to be big enough. Seven. Think this way. You use micrometers all the time, you forget how they work. That's 800 less. This. I don't think this bit's that important because it sits on top. But it's 800, 780, 75 plus 85, 86, 70, 88. 788, 788 thou is the white bit. So I need something big enough to make it with. Unfortunately, that's got a hole through the middle of it. So there. I've got a bit of tool steel somewhere. First look. Steel's not easy for it. This is hardened steel. Feet. So we're still in 1080p, 60 frames. That's a new insert I got, CCMT. Just gotta give it a go. Positive. I buy one insert at a time and then I forget which one I bought. Just to try them, you know, see what works best. CNMG is usually a good bet, right? Right. Shim that back till it's solid. Right, that's my size. So I'm machining down to this. And we can put you on top of there. Yep. You okay there? This is the damaged lens and on here now it's not going to matter so much because I can change it. Right. So far, we can do that a little bit. Let me just turn it around actually.
out, cutting 60.
Seven, seven, eight, five. $7.90. $4,500 to go. I'll do a flex pass and I think that'll do it. Thank you. a little bit. This bit, I don't think it's that important to be mangling. Needed. 86. Within a thou. Good practice. Right. What I need now is to get rid of that hole so we can calculate them.
Yeah.
We're going to try and make this bit. Okay, well, we've not got enough material yet. We need to come hard against the jaws, so we'll pull it out a wee bit. I hope it stays true. I think it's about a 3 fibre on it. Three jaws, about right. And steel rod that machines really nice. It's usually got the bend in it when you get it around. Down. 4:80 and we're at 6:40. 40, 120, 120 and 40, 160 to go. Six to go. 60. Let's turn this thing up because it'll go faster than it used to. RPM. This one needs to be right because it's to come up through 525 and we're wanting 470, 15, 20, 15 and then we'll measure it. 10. About a fourth out to go. Probably take that with a bit of sunlight on it. Four to go. Okay, I'll cut it. And that's the finished article I've got made. I've left the top a bit thicker and the bottom's the same. That's the bit that's broken off, of course. Well, give you an idea. So that one's a bit stronger. I'm not sure if that was made in one or could have been, it probably was, I would have thought. Same as that, made that in one. Somebody must have got pretty vicious with the brakes, I think. That's the shoes it sits in to there. And when the bolts go in, the whole thing can still move.
I'll have to put all this back together.
And tramming it all in. I've got a dial indicator come today, so see how it goes. Anyway, and I've got the motor mount tidied up and 3 coats of primer on it so far. Probably another coat of finish on tomorrow, or a couple of coats of finish while I'm building the rest up. So, bit of fun.
That's the Bridgeport all put back together with a new brake mechanism in, which is working. I've just got to tram the head now. Just waiting on that's an 8mm, just waiting on a 10mm one of them coming, and then I can use this with a super big gauge, just sweep it around that disc to tram it in, and then I've got the vise in and tram it in as well,
that arm's off of this magnetic mount. So it's been customised, because the minute I moved the screw, the head broke off it. So I re-drilled it and re-tapped it, M6, and I machined up this little adapter. Happened to be M8 at that end, so that will go into an M10 collet, one of them. And that will give us, it's the least amount of adapters for tramming it in, because you're going straight up in there into the B9. Even better if you can see it. You're going straight up in here. No, you're not putting a chuck in or anything to, you know, but it's direct as you can. I always think this thing looks squint, but it can't be that far off. So, another job for another day. Maybe tomorrow, we'll see.